Sure. We'll try.
Yes!
We'll try.
Kitchen science.
Thanks, ma'am.
You're welcome.
Can I go upstairs now for the crunch for a zig and zag? Thanks!
As you can see, viewers, I'm here with Audrey, who's the nan from our family of the week.
So now,
Audrey's
Chris.
What?
Do I look like Audrey Nan of the week?
That's the next page.
You're in the wrong page.
You've done all that.
You just called me Audrey.
It's the crunch.
Yeah!
in your face, mister!
She's very
Wake
nice,
up,
though.
You're
she's
nice.
A lovely nan of the
week. Audrey, the nan of the family. She's lovely.
She is lovely.
Got a tip for you. Don't call her granny. She's a nan.
She's a nan.
You know how, like, nans want to be grannies or nans?
Yeah.
She's going for the nan
it's
option.
It's like bananas.
It is. Only not yellow.
Look at this. Yeah. It's incredible. The resemblance. Daniel Brown's friend sent this in. He looks exactly like my brother.
I wouldn't say exactly. But we know what you mean. It's a good way of getting on television anyway.
Yeah, I know
what's a good way of getting on television as well.
Actually, Chris, he looks about as close to Zig as I do to Audrey, Nan of the Week.
I think you're right there, Zaggy boy.
He does look like Audrey.
It's Tuesday,
Chris.
And you've got the hat on.
Yeah.
It can only mean one thing.
Agony Alien!
Okay, quiet everybody, come on.
This is very, very serious. Real problems.
Have you seen Sophie Lawrence around?
Wow.
Have you seen her?
Yeah.
Where? We've been looking for her all morning.
No.
Oh, was it?
Oh, no, Chris.
Right, nor have we. Carry on. Have you, Zig?
What?
Nothing?
Yes,
you're one of the girl. Okay, well...
Look, come on, everyone.
Chris,
come on,
this letter, actually, I've picked this out of many letters, and this happens to be a very, very serious one, because...
Okay.
Well, Zig wanted to really help someone this morning, and this is it. Mm-hmm.
All right, lovely.
Dear Zig.
You ready?
We both have a very serious problem. When we go to dry up the washing up, we put the forks into the knife compartment.
Start again.
Oh, no, okay. I'm confused. Chris, there was that whole Audrey thing really got me going. Dear Zig, we both have a very serious problem. When we go to
no,
dry up...
No, come on,
up...
now wait one moment. Look, can we stop all the sniggering, please?
There's a lot of sniggering.
Look,
a lot of sniggering going on.
Brav the cameraman, for goodness sake.
No, this is serious,
very jolly. Now come along.
We have a good
come
all
on,
day.
Everyone. There really are people out there.
We've
got to help them.
His answer must
come
be
on,
short.
Come on, everyone.
What?
Sorry.
Okay.
Dear Zig,
we both have a very serious problem. When we go to dry up, we put the forks into the knife compartment.
No!
We are getting into the habit of doing this. It is completely shattering our lives. Please help us. Love, Cuthbert and Rodney.
Golly gosh. Gosh, 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 gosh.
Golly gosh.
Cuthbert and Rodney. Statistic. 3 out of every 10 adults suffer from acute cuddly sortitis.
Oh, really?
Yes.
What was that? Is it a condition?
Acute cuddly sortitis. So look, you're not alone, lovey. It is an agonising problem. I know. But it reverts back to an even deeper problem.
Reverts?
One that you're not probably aware of from years and years and years back. Because putting a fork into a knife compartment is a sign of confusion, lovey. Now, listen. I want you to think back. Were you ever attacked? Were you ever attacked by a big doggy, lovey? Can you remember? Mm-hmm. Now, think really hard. I don't want you to fight it, no matter how painful. Because I can tell you now, what might help, and it's only my suggestion, lovey, is a separate drawer for forks and a different drawer for knives.
He's a genius!
He is
and
a
that
genius.
Big, nasty doggy,
and are you
that big, nasty doggy will fade away from your memory and never, ever come back.
Yes! Yes.
It's not just you!
It's us
two! It's in your face!
More
it's problems! It's
26! More problems! Two real problems!
He's my brother!
We can only deal with the ten problems,
yeah,
can't we?
Indeed, Christopher. Another problem we have is this question about the
nice. Nice.
I came in there with the...
Go on,
okay, what's the person in the headscarf trying to hide? And remember, don't hold it just upon.
I gave you an order, woman!
Beautiful.
And you're very strong.
Thank you.
I did think baby wipes were all the same.
Yeah, just driving her crazy.
Excellent work, son.
Thanks, Dad. 8:49, welcome back to The Big Breakfast. The question about the clip was, what did he do? And the answer was nothing. And you can see Roseanne on Channel 4 tonight at 6:30 p.m. You having a nice rest? Would you like a licorice all sort? Mm-hmm. Yes? Mm-hmm. Okay, there we are. There we are, Robbie. See, we look after our camera crew here. Time to go upstairs now for the crunch. How about another marshmallow? Mm.
Yeah! Sophie, in your face!
Sophie!
Hi, Sophie.
You're just back.
I am, I'm back.
My goodness, it's going to be some show, I tell you, tonight. EastEnders, I can't wait. Sophie Lawrence is here in the bathroom. She's back.
She's here. She's here.
Sophie!
Okay, what?
Sophie, do you have a new boyfriend? Like, he's very good out with a French man, because that's what you were.
She's straight in with the question.
Well, I'm sorry about that, but I have to know.
Well, I might have one. I have been there over 2 years now, so there's a good chance.
Chris, go. What? Get action shot.
Okay, yes. Listen, we've got some good questions for you here.
You've got some good questions?
Yeah, nice to see you.
Sophie Lawrence, back in the tennis tonight.
Yeah. Around and about.
Have you really?
You've got all grown up since you were last in the East Desert.
Have I got all grown up?
But in a nice way.
But thank you.
We can tell when you're grown up, because before, when you came in, we could not possibly have said what we say now when you come in, which is, hello.
Because remember, when I was, before I was grown up, I was only this tall.
Yeah.
And now, because I've grown up a bit more, I'm this tall.
Yeah, okay.
But probably next year, I'll probably be this tall.
Okay, now we have question number one.
Don't look at me like that. She's looking at me.
Sophie Lawrence, here's a question. You are about to make a huge comeback in the EastEnders tonight. Please give us an exclusive preview of your very first line.
Dad.
Huh? Wow. Thank you very much indeed.
Wow.
Question number two.
Okay, here we go. A bit of a tricky one here. Sophie Lawrence, you are about to make a huge comeback in EastEnders. Your character has spent an awful long time in French France. I will now say three French phrases. Can you translate them into Cockney for us? Okay, you ready?
Yes.
Je laisse moi, je te prends, j'ai que la baisse de goût.
You on the dog and bone again, treacle.
That means, of course, are you on the telephone, which is dog and bone again, treacle, which is treacle tart, sweetheart. Are you on the telephone again, sweetheart?
That's correct.
Thank you.
And number B is...
Number B!
Balamajour!
Number B?
Well, it's letter B!
Okay, number two. Okay. Balamajour,
right. Stone me, sharp new whistle and flute you got there, Governor.
What's that, Chris?
Well, that means, goodness me, nice new suit you've got there, mister.
Nice new suit. She's correct!
That's right.
She's indeed, I'm the third!
Right, this one. Just one, thank you.
Me!
Oh, I've run out of film, actually.
Oh, let's go!
The third French saying is...
Letter three.
Oh, je le sais, rejeune de Beron, lui le bon.
That's good,
isn't it? Sophie, what's happening?
I came across it down the apples and pears this morning.
Which means, of course, I had a bit of a tumble down the stairs today.
That is correct!
Okay!
Oh, Sophie Lawrence!
Question number three to Sophie Lawrence. Sophie Lawrence, you are about to make a huge comeback in EastEnders.
Yes, she is.
Your character has spent an awful long time gone on film list. In French. So can you now identify these three French objects? Are you ready?
Yes.
Sorry, I'm ready.
Object A!
Sorry.
It's
Object
Sophie.
A.
Oh, no,
yeah.
Number one.
A French onion.
It is a French onion.
Wow.
Oh, sorry.
Not just a pretty face. By golly, no. By golly, no. What's that?
A French stick.
It certainly is, isn't it?
Can I have it?
Okay, I'm finally...
Stop that!
A French fry.
It is a French fry!
Wow.
Well done! Congratulations. That's about it then, as far as that's concerned.
Thank you.
Got some video games now, though. You're gonna have to.
Oh, indeed we have.
I certainly will.
But there's good you know.
But first, the crunch in 3D. Get your glasses, Mrs. Woo! 3D. It's in your living room. Woo! What's like it's real? Oh, sorry. It slipped.
Dick Bell! Oh,
this
God,
is the whole bit of the program will be over and the whole thing will have done again. Because everyone knows this is Master Blaster and indeed it's Game 1. Game 1, Super Shinobi.
Everybody knows that this is the boring bit.
If you didn't catch Shinobi 1 or 2, let's just say he's one of those scary ninja type characters you don't want to mess with. Watch him swing from spiry cave ceilings, swords and knives whirling in all directions as he faces frightful warriors from all sorts. Shinobi's agility and special blade wielding techniques are fast and impressive. The variety of his functions and overall pace of the game may well keep you interested if you haven't seen it all before. Out September approximately.
Wow!
$39.99 on the Mega Drive.
That's good, isn't it?
Yes!
Do you like that?
I look very excited.
Do you play games at all?
Well, I do play a bit, but not very.
Have you got a Sega or a Nintendo?
I've got a Sega.
Okay.
A Sega. Have
you got a Mega Drive?
Well, yeah. Top of this, don't be, because game number two is on the Super Nintendo system.
Very nice.
Super Mario All-Stars, King of the Plumbers, and Platform Games is back. Mario hasn't exactly aborted any new adventures, Chris. Stop! He's no new adventures here, but this is a good chance to get Super Mario Brothers 1, 2, and 3 as well as the US first. Yes, indeed. All on one get lost. All on one Super Nintendo card. Yes, indeed. This breathes more life into the Mario than even Bob Hoskins could have dreamed. I wrote that line myself. Stop the tickling. It's serious. No, it is.
I do believe you're getting somewhat perturbed.
Our top quality, long-lasting play.
I came out with a
rash.
Wait for this. Guess how much that game was. Japanese import, Super Nintendo.
$79.99.
50. 50
quid.
Okay. 50 Spondaluno.
Okay.
Game number three.
Not another one.
You will think of this, Sophie. Flash on the Sega Master System. Yes, indeed. Believe the classic comic book capers on Flash as he speeds and spins his way around the central city in pursuit of a loathsome trickster and trackman who plans to take over. This game combines the atmosphere of the moody neon-lit streets of America in the 50s and 90s style technology. One of the most enjoyable platform games around, and the presentation is way above average for the Master System at September $29.99. And that's my bit of
Chris!
Oh, no!
Chris!
Put it back in the bath!
It's only inflatable. It's all right.
Yes, but Chris, they can be dangerous if you go out too far in the ocean with them.
Brilliant. Okay, now, look how new those games were. Game number one. Here
not it even out. It's on microchip.
Wow. What is it again?
Wow.
That one there, game number one, Super Shinobi 3.
Okay. Game number two we have there.
Yes, that's in its box. That's Super Mario All-Stars. Japanese import only, mind.
Game number three.
Flash on the Sega Master System. That's the top game of the day. That one, Flash, you'd like that.
I like that. I like that.